Assalamu alaikum, I am very good morning to all of you. Now today we will continue with the same topic, that is the revision of first chapter. Okay. So in our previous lecture we discussed about some of the properties related to the rational numbers as well as the whole number as well as the integers. Now today we will proceed further with our next property, and that is the associativity. Now what do you mean by association or associativity? Okay. So the association or the associativity for the four operations of whole numbers, for the four operations for the integers, and for the four operations for the rational numbers also. So first of all, I will proceed with the whole numbers. Okay. So first thing is the association or associativity. Okay. Suppose I am taking the whole number. Listen here. While explaining all the properties, I just take the example in order to explain you all the properties. So going with the whole number, keep this in mind. Whole number karwaunga, uske saath uski char operation karunga. That is the addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. After that, we will go for the integers. So we will repeat the same four operation, and after that is the rational number. Whether they are associative or not, understand or not. So first operation, that is the addition of a whole number. Okay, we will check whether it prove the associativity or not. Understand or not? Suppose I am taking three of the, first of all, what do you mean by association or the associativity for addition? So A plus B plus C, if it is given in this way, that A plus B plus C, you can write it as A plus B plus C in this way also. That means what? The result you obtain on the RHS, that is equal to the LHS. So then we have second and third term, we don't have a summation, and with the first term, and here we are taking the bracket with the first and the second term, and that is added to the third term. Understand or not? So we will check whether it is applicable for a whole number or not. If I am taking any of the whole numbers, suppose I am taking 0, 0 plus 2 plus 3. Okay, so that is equal to how much? 0 plus 2 plus 3, that is equal to how much? 5. Okay, I am applying this thing. Okay, now we will check for the RHS also. Whether these three whole numbers give the answer that is equal to 5 or not. Okay, so 0 plus 2 plus, that is equal to 0 plus 2, that is 2, and 2 plus 3, that is equal to 5. Understand or not? So just check by both of the matter, we are obtaining the same answer, that is how much? 5. So you can say that the addition of whole number is associative. Understand or not? Okay, means we can use the associativity for the addition of a whole number. Understand or not? Okay, now after that, for the subtraction, we will go for the subtraction also. But why taking the subtraction? Okay, I am taking one of the examples. Suppose 7 minus 5 minus 2. Okay, and another term is how much? 7 minus 5 minus 2. We will check whether we are obtaining right answer or not. Means iska answer or iska answer same aata hai. If you are using the subtraction for the associativity, so you can say that the subtraction of a whole number is associative. Agar nahi aata equal answer, that means what? The subtraction of a whole number is not an associative. So 7 minus 5 minus 2, that is equal to how much? 3. Understand or not? 7 minus 3, that is equal to how much? 4. Okay. Now 4, yaha bhi answer aana chahiye. Agar aata hai, you can say that it is associative. Agar nahi aata, you can't say that it's associative. Okay. So 7 minus 5, that is equal to how much? 2 minus 2. So that is equal to how much? 0. Just check both of the answers. That is 4 and 0. That is what? Both of the answer is different. That is not equal. Understand or not? So you can say that it is not associative. That is, the subtraction of whole number is not associative. Understand? That means what? You cannot apply the associativity for the subtraction of a whole number. Understand? Now for the multiplication, addition of where, subtraction of where, or multiplication of a whole number. Suppose 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 0. Why I am counting here majority is 0, because 0 is considered as a whole number. Okay, so that is equal to. And another one is 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 0. We will check both of the answers, whether it is So 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 0, and the multiplied by 0, that is equals to 0. So 2 multiplied by 0, that is equals to 0. And here it is the 2 multiplied by 3, that is 6, and 6 multiplied by 0, so that is also equals to 0. Understand or not? You can apply for any other number also. So this shows what both of the answer is same. That means what the multiplication of whole number is associative. Understand or not? And in the same way, we know the example of the scientific where the division of a whole number is not associative. Majority, when you know that subtraction or division, many problems are there. Otherwise, addition and multiplication are competitive also, and they are associative also. Now moving further, for the integers, okay. Now it's a little bit different for the integers, okay. Suppose I am taking, you can take any of the integer, positive integer or negative integer, okay. Suppose I am taking minus 2 plus 3 plus minus, okay. I am taking in this. Now as we are applying associativity, so इसमें क्या होता है कि पहले bracket में second और third term का addition है, तो that is equals to first and the second term addition, okay, in the bracket. So we will check that is minus 2 plus 3 bracket plus okay. Now we will check for it whether both are obtained, we are obtaining the same answer or not. The same answer आता है, it is associative. Understand or not? So minus 2 plus, now 3 plus minus 4. So देखो यहाँ पर ये addition अच्छे तरीके से समझो. How you can do the addition? Okay. Suppose आपको दो number का, दो integers का addition करना है. उसमें एक integer positive है और दूसरा negative है. अच्छे तरीके से सुनो. एक positive है और दूसरा negative है. अगर ये condition में आपको addition करना है, तो आपको क्या करना पड़ेगा? दोनों number के बीच subtraction करना पड़ेगा. Means 4 minus 3 करो तो कितना आंसर आएगा? 4 minus 3 is equal to how much होगा? Understand or not? Okay. अब 1 लिखने के बाद दोनों में से बड़ा number कौन सा है? Means जो digit है वो कौन सा बड़ा है? Here 3 is there and here 4 is there. Please यहाँ आप minus count करके दिमाग में मत चलो कि भाई minus है तो minus 4 छोटा है as compared to 3. No. We have to just see the number or the digit. कौन सी बड़ी digit है? Sign that it is minus, so it is minus. Okay, not that is it. So now, अब देखो यहाँ एक example तो मैं कुछ एक method तो सीख ली. अबे आप दूसरी method. If there is the addition between two negative integers, दोनों ही negative integers और दोनों के बीच addition है, तो आप क्या करोगे? जो दो number हैं, इस दोनों digit को add करोगे. So 2 plus 1, that is equals how much? 3. And both are negative values, so it is minus. It is minus. You understand or not? So you will apply here also. First of all, minus 2 plus 3. So here the same method is a negative integer, a positive integer, common which is summation. So what we will do, as I explained you, that subtract both of them. So 3 minus 2, so 3 is 2, that is equal to how much? 1. And which digit is bigger? So it is 3. And 3 contains 3 is which? That is positive. So plus 1. So you can write it as 1 also. Plus minus 4. You have to apply the same thing because 1 is positive integer and 1 is negative integer. The subtraction between both of them is 4 minus 1, that is equal to how much? 3 and 4 containing the negative sign, so it is minus 3. So just check both of the answer, minus 3 and minus 3. Means both of the answer is same, so you can see that the addition of integers is associative. Understand or not? The addition of integers is associative. Okay. Now the subtraction of integers. So the subtraction of integers is not associative. You keep this in mind. The subtraction of integers is not associative. Okay. You can take any example. आप अपने according के example use करके subtraction check कर सकते हो whether it is associative or not. Means subtraction of the integers whether it is associative or not. You can check by yourself also. Understand or not? Okay. Now proceeding further with the multiplication. We will check for the multiplication. Okay. Minus 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by minus 2. I am taking this negative integer, positive integer, negative. Okay. And another one that is minus 2 So here minus 2 as it is multiplied by, listen here, while solving this, first of all try to solve the bracket first. After understand one. So 3 multiplied by 4, so 3 4 is a 12. Now listen here, when that is a multiplication, when that is a, iske pehle jo maine explanation diya tha, that is for addition. Now when that is a multiplication, this thing you already learned in the 7th standard also. So when that is a multiplication between a positive integer and a negative integer, so plus multiplied by minus, so plus is minus, understand or not? So this minus that is equal to, now the number you have to multiply by digit, that is 2 multiplied by 12, so 2 12s or 12 2s, you can write it as 24. Now here both the integers are negative, so the answer is positive, that is plus 24, understand or not? Now we will check for this also, here we have whether we have any plus 24 the answer or not, understand or not? So 2, 3 is a 6. 1 is negative, another one is positive, so the answer is minus 6 multiplied by minus 2. Right, 6 folds are right now, 24 and plus 25, so minus minus plus. So we are obtaining both the answers same, that is plus 24 and plus 24. So you can say that the multiplication of the integers is associative, understand or not? Okay, and the division of integer are not associative. Keep this in mind. So here addition and the multiplications are only associative, but subtraction and division are non-associative. Now we will go for the rational number. We will check what the rational number. I can take the example from the book, that is minus 2 upon 3. Listen here, I am taking an easy example by taking the same denominator, so that will be easier for you to understand. Okay, so 5 upon 3 minus 5 upon 3 plus 7 upon 3. Just see, here we are taking the bracket and in this way. Suppose this is one of the rational number, negative, negative and positive. Okay, now we will check for the RHS of associativity. So it is minus 2 upon 3 plus minus 5 upon 3 plus 7 upon 3. Which are both of the answers we are obtaining their same format. If it is same, so it is associative. So that is equal to. As I told you that first of all try to solve the bracket. So minus 2 upon 3 plus, now same denominator, so upon 3 minus 5 plus 7. So that is equal to minus 2 upon 3 plus minus 5 plus 7, that is 2 upon 3. Okay, so 2 upon 3 plus minus 2 upon 3 and plus 2 upon 3, that is equal to how much? 0. Why? Because 1 is positive and 1 is negative, both of the rational numbers are, the value of both of the rational numbers are same. So we will apply for here also, we are obtaining whether we are obtaining 0 or not. So first of all solving these two, so as it is, so minus 2 plus minus 5 upon 3 plus 7 upon 3, so that is equal to, now minus 2 plus minus 5, when you do one that addition can be wrong, negative integers are, so we have that both of them, so minus 2 minus 5, that is minus 7 upon 3 plus 7 upon 3, that is equal to how much also, that is equal to 0. So here we are obtaining both of the values, that is the same, so you can say that the addition of a rational number is associative, understand or not? So the addition of a rational number is associative and the subtraction of a rational number is not associative, understand or not? So the subtraction of a rational number is not associative and the multiplication of a, listen here, the addition and the multiplication of a rational number are associative, but the subtraction and the division of a rational number are non-associative, means addition or multiplication is only associative and subtraction and division they are not will be, they will not will be associated. Understand? Yes, another next topic is the role of zero. That means what? What will be the answer if you add zero in any number? So if 0 plus 7, so what will be the answer? The 7. That is the number itself. You already aapko pata hai. It is very easy. And if you multiply with 0 in any number, so the answer will be 0. If it remains as it is, understand? Also, if you will obtain 0. Understand? Now the rule of 1. That means what? You all know that 1 multiply with any number, so that will give you that number. Understand? Okay? And so here only the multiplication of 1 is given to you. If you multiply 1 with the whole number, so you will obtain that whole number. If you multiply 1 with the integer, you will obtain the same integer. And if you multiply 1 with the rational number, so you will obtain the same rational number. Understand? So here add for the 0 also. That means what? If you add 0 with any of the number, that is whole number, integers or the rational number, you will obtain that same. That is the whole number, that same integer and that same are rational number. Understand? If you multiply 0 with any of the three of them, you will obtain the answer as 0. Understand? Okay. Now the next topic is the reciprocal. Okay. So all of you know about the reciprocal. So already 7th standard for you. Suppose I am giving a number to you, that is 1 upon 2. So what is the reciprocal of 1 upon 2? That is equal to how much? 2 upon 1. Means up to kya karna hai? Denominator ko numerator pe le lena, numerator ko denominator pe le lena. 2 upon 1. Understand? Suppose I am giving 3. So what is the reciprocal of 3? So you can write 3 as in the p by 2 form, that is as 3 upon 1. So what is the reciprocal of 3? That is equal to 1 upon 3. Understand? Okay. After that, additive inverse. All of you familiar with the additive inverse also. Suppose 2 is there. So what is the additive inverse of 2? What is the additive inverse of 2? So the additive inverse of 2 is how much? Minus 2. If it is 2 upon 3, so what is the additive inverse of 2 upon 3? That is equal to how much? Minus 2 upon 3. Dekho, additive inverse mein sirf yahan positive hai to negative hoga. Pata chala ki nahi. Yahan reciprocal nahi hoga. Keep this in mind. Only additive inverse ke andar. Understand or not? Reciprocal ka matlab kya hai? Ulta de diya. Okay? Aur and additive inverse ka matlab kya hai? Agar positive hai to negative aur negative hai to positive. Keep this in mind. Understand or not? So thank you very much and have a good day. Okay? So our next property, that is distributivity. Okay? Please try to practice at your home. Otherwise, I will explain you in our next lecture. And after that, we will take some of the examples, okay, from our first exercise. And after that, I will explain you how you can place the number or how you can plot a number on a number line. Understand? Okay, so thank you very much and have a good day. Please try and practice much more and more at your home. Thank you very much and have a good day.